Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video. Now, if you've transitioned to smartphones for your video recording and using the more later devices such as the iPhone 15 Pro and the Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra or the Google Pixel 9, you're probably aware you're going to get some fantastic video quality. But if you want to use even higher quality video productions, you're going to be using something like a third-party app such as the Blackmagic Cinema app or Final Cut Pro, which is available now on both Android and iOS devices. With those apps, you can actually shoot in RAW format and ProRes and that sort of thing. But these create large files, which if you've got a smartphone with only 64 or 128 gigabytes of memory, you're very quickly going to run out of internal storage. So you're probably aware that you can transition to something like an SD device, plug that into the camera, and you can actually record externally to a device. And you get facilities within those programs to select that SSD drive as the recording source rather than the internal memory. Very easy. All you have to do is connect the SSD drive via the USB-C to your smartphone, set the device to external recording to that device, and you can fire away and shoot for extended periods of time. But that does give you a problem if you want to use something like a wireless microphone at the same time. You've only got the one port on the smartphone, so if it's being taken up by the SSD drive, you don't have that facility of connecting your receiver for, say, your wireless device. So if I wanted to use my home Micro One system, then I can't use that simultaneously with the SSD drive. But there is a solution, and I've come up with an idea which I developed along with the SSD drive and other peripherals, is to use a USB-C hub. Now, I've got one here which I purchased on Amazon, and I'll put links in the video description below. It is a four-port USB-C hub with a connecting cable which is about just over 30 centimeters long, so it's long enough to fit on something like a camera rig. So if I was going to be using it on my little camera rig here, I can mount my smartphone. This is cable tied to the top of the device. I can mount my wireless transmitter and receiver on this device and use it quite conveniently. So this will allow four devices to be plugged into the USB-C hub. It's a 10 gigabits per second hub, so it's quite fast and will record 4K onto your SSD drive. See here, I've got a 256 SSD, but I've also got a 512 SSD. So it's a simple case of plugging this into the smartphone, plug your SSD into the hub, and then if I wanted to use my wireless mic, I can then just plug this into one of the ports on the SSD hub. That will get its power from the smartphone and allow me to use the device. First of all, let me plug the USB hub into the smartphone, show you how you can set the external drive in the Blackmagic Cinema Pro app, and then we'll see how we can record audio, either by using an external Bluetooth mic, so we won't actually need to use the hub for that reason, and if we want to use a wired lavalier microphone with the USB-C plug, we can use that directly into the hub. We can also use a TRS lavalier microphone if we use a TRS dongle into the device as well. So we'll look at those options to record audio into the system. So you can see here on the desktop now, I plugged in the USB-C hub. Into that hub, I've now got the SSD drive plugged into it, and the hub is plugged into the USB-C port of the iPhone 15 Pro. To validate that the fact that the drive is operational, we can use the files command on the phone. So let me just open that up. And on my desktop here, you can see we've got the files command. So I'm going to actually start screen recording at the same time, and that will give me the option of giving you the screenshot as well as the overall video. So let's go back to the files command now. We touch files and we go browse. you can see that one of the options here in locations is now that 256 gigabyte drive. You might just notice here on the desktop as well, the light flashes as we access it. So I'm going to open the drive just to see the files, see the blue access sliders come on. I've got a folder here called New Images. If I click on that, you can see I've already got files in there. So let's go back. If I wanted to create a new folder for our recording, then if we go to the three dots at the top, click on New Folder, it will create a new folder on that drive. I can rename this and we'll call it Test. And then we have that file. Obviously, there's nothing in there. We can now go to our recording app, which in this case, I'm going to use the Blackmagic Cinema app. So if I just go through to that, start the Blackmagic Cinema app. So at the moment, it's going to be recording to another file structure, and this is flashing red. So I need to change the location of where the file is stored. So again, if we go into settings on the app, if we look at the main screen, if we scroll down to save clips under the media format, so save clips to, if we just check that, back to browse, go to the drive we just selected, so that's that 256 drive, and to the folder called Test, and then open that. You now see that it's files and it's in directory test. So we now know that the files are going to be saved to the test directory, which is on the SSD drive. We can go back. So at the moment, the audio is set, if we look at this, to the iPhone microphone. So at the moment, it's connecting to the iPhone. So let's just do a very quick recording using this camera to the SSD drive, using the internal. So let's just go back to the camera setting. See, at the moment I've got this set to HEVC, that's H265 4K Rec 709 25 frames per second. So we'll just go to the camera. So this is a test recording using the iPhone 15 Pro. We're using the internal microphone of the iPhone 15 Pro, and we're saving the files to the 256 gigabyte external SSD drive. If I wanted just to check that media, then I can go to the media folder, and you can see that it's recorded that clip there, 42 seconds worth of video. Couldn't play it back because I've got this, I should be able to play it back because I've got no external device connected to here. So let's just play that back to show that it has worked. This is a test recording using the internal microphone of the iPhone 15 Pro, and we're saving the files to the... There we go. So it has recorded that to the SSD drive. Go back to the camera. For the first external device I'm going to plug into that USB-C port, I'm just going to use my standard USB-C enabled lavalier microphone. So I'm going to plug that into the port. I'll just click that at the same place as my Sennheiser lav mic going into the main camera. So I'm going to plug this into one of the USB-C ports. If we take a quick look at the settings, now under audio, you'll find that the audio source is USB audio because that's what it's picked up. We can go back to the camera, and again, I'll do a quick recording. So the first test is with a lavalier microphone, one which has a USB-C ADC device attached to it. So it's plugged directly into that USB hub. So this is the iPhone 15 Pro, the USB-C hub, recording to the SSD via the USB hub, and simultaneously recording the audio using this lovely microphone with the standard USB ADC device on it. Now for the next test, I'm going to be using a standard lavalier microphone, which is normally used with the smartphone. This one's got a TRRS connector on, so to use that, I'm going to be using a TRRS to USB-C DAC. And again, I'll plug that into the hub. If we go into the settings, just to confirm that we've got a audio source, we'll change that to KT USB audio. That is the adapter here, so I'm going to switch over to that. Go back to the camera. Let me just plug this here. So the second audio test is with a standard lavalier microphone. It's a TRRS plug, which is designed to go into your older smartphone or into the smartphone with a later dongle. So this is with the dongle, a TRRS adapter, plugged into the USB-C port of the USB hub and simultaneously recording video from the camera onto the SSD, which again is plugged into that USB-C hub. So now we're going to be using an external wireless microphone. It's the Hohem Mico 1. So I'm going to plug the receiver first of all into a port on the USB-C hub. So plug that into a spare port. You can see that it's energized. We've got the two flashing blue lights. It's now waiting for the transmitter to be turned on. So I'm just going to turn on the transmitter. We've got a solid green light and a solid green light on channel 2, which means we've got communication. So I'm just going to plug this onto my shirt. And again, we can see we've got audio coming from the device. And to check that, let's go into settings. We'll go up to the source and you can see that it's automatically switched over to the Mico 1. So the source for the audio now is from this receiver here. So we go back to the camera setting and again we'll do just a quick recording using the Mico 1. So this is audio now using the Hohem Mico 1. So the microphone is here on my shirt pocket and the receiver is plugged into the USB-C hub and we're recording video simultaneously onto the SSD, which is also plugged into that USB-C hub. So we've seen now how we can use the USB-C hub to support wireless microphones simultaneously with the SSD drive to record external files rather than recording onto the internal file structure of your iPhone. Now I'm going to look at the other option for wireless microphone, which is the standard, say, Rode Wireless Go. And again, I'm using the output from the receiver through a ADC converter, which is in this case I think it's Saramonic. It's TRS to USB-C. So I'm going to plug that into the hub and we'll record some audio using the Rode Wireless Go. So you can now see on the desktop I've got the Rode Wireless Go 2 plugged into the USB-C hub. If we can just power the receiver on them again so I can see the display. You can see I'm using channel 2. That's a transmitter on channel 2. You can see we've got connectivity, got two blue lights, and we've got the right sound levels on the meter. So I'm going to plug this here onto my shirt collar and we'll record some audio and video as we've done in the previous example. So we'll just check the settings to make sure that we are looking at the correct audio. So the audio source is now microphone, which is going to be the adapter. So we've got the right source. Go back to the camera. So this is a test using the Rode Wireless Go 2 system. The microphone is here on my shirt pocket. The receiver, again, is plugged into the USB-C hub via a 3.5mm to USB-C ADC device, which is built into the plug. So again, the video is being recorded on the SSD, simultaneously plugged into that USB-C hub. So you can see now we've got good audio from the Rode Wireless Go 2 system through that TRS ADC converter plugged into that USB-C hub. It is possible to use that USB-C hub for other purposes. You might want to plug in a SD card reader and transfer files from your SD card over to your SSD, or conversely, take files from your SSD and transfer them over to the SD card in the SD card reader. You can also plug a USB keyboard in there. So if you're going to be using your smartphone for taking notes or whatever, you can plug that into the hub simultaneously with your SSD drive. If you're going to save your files to your SSD, you can use that USB-C port for that purpose as well. Can't use it for a mouse, obviously, with the iPhone because you're using a touch screen, but you can use it for the keyboard, and it's a useful feature if you're taking documents and things, etc. One of the other options you have if you're using earbuds is to use the dongle, so you can actually connect the earbuds through USB-C. So I've got a USB-C adapter here, which is the TRRS to USB-C. So there's a DAC and a audio digital converter in this device to allow you to use those earbuds. So you can actually record the audio and play back the audio using this device. You don't have to keep unplugging the audio source. So we'll just check with the settings, and we can see that under the audio, you can see we're using the KM Air Hi-Fi connector, which is the one plugged into the port here. So let's go back and just shoot some video. So this audio test is using the supplied earbuds, which are the wide earbuds for the iPhone 15. And we're using the supplied ADC DAC for the headset and microphone. The microphone is this EMS device here, which is built into the lead of the right-hand headset. The advantage of this system is that when you replay it, you can hear the audio back through the headphones. Some of the audio devices plugged into the USB-C port don't allow you to hear the audio and you've got to disconnect them. But with the earbuds, as an experiment, I've just tried these wireless earbuds. They're a very, very cheap pair. They're isn't about £25 for the pair, so they're not very good quality. But they have an inbuilt microphone system, so we should be able to see that on the audio. So this test is using some Bluetooth earbuds. You can probably just see them here. They're not the Apple earbuds. These are just a cheap pair of earbuds, Bluetooth connected, and the app can pick them up in the audio source. So we're using that to provide the audio. There looks to be a little bit of Bluetooth delay there, but we'll see that in the final video. So this is Bluetooth earbuds to provide the audio for the video. So this final audio test is using this Saramonic device, which masquerades itself as the Blink Go 2. So it's labeled Saramonic, and it's a wireless microphone system with the receiver again plugged into that USB-C hub. The microphone here on my shirt pocket, you can see it's labeled Saramonic, but the actual description coming back from the device is Blink 2 Go. Hope you found that useful. If you're a new viewer and you're liking what you see, why not hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised then when I upload new videos to the channel. If you've not seen my photographic blog, there's lots more information on a whole raft of ideas in photography and electronics. Particularly for Panasonic Lumix bridge camera users, there's a whole section there on virtually every bridge camera that Panasonic have produced. So why not check that out? There'll be a link to that in the video description below. So until the next video, thanks again for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.